Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, real talk, carrying a Manurhin MR73 as a CCW. So I just wanted to get into this and talk about this Manurhin MR73 again, because after my last video about the Glock, I guess a lot of people got, I don't know if they got upset, but they were like scratching their head like, whoa, that's, we never saw that coming. But so this Glock right here is what I'm carrying right now. And it's interesting, I'm actually shooting a DA essay that's really turning me on. It's called the Storm full size, and I'm thinking about trying to find a compact of that because I'm shooting that one so well also without a red dot. I don't know, we'll see where all this goes. All right, give me some time here. But after the video on this gun right here, I guess some people are like, wait, what happened to your revolvers? And someone did mention, like, I thought you were going to try to carry that Manurhin MR73. Oh, you didn't do it, huh? So let's talk about this fine revolver right here. Now, this is an incredible revolver, all right? And I know I did say that I was going to carry this revolver as a primary CCW back when I got it. So what happened was basically I got this earlier this year, fine revolver, and I definitely wanted to carry this. The problem was I couldn't find a holster for it. I know a lot of people say just look at an L-frame, and I did do that. You know, it does kind of work, and now that I think about it, I should have just, gotten a similar, like, shaped holster that would probably work with this MR73. But back then, I did get two different holsters from Kraft. Okay, so Kraft holster here is a pancake. This one's made by Falco. This is more of a belt holster. And, okay, this one here probably worked out the best, I guess. Well, I don't want to say the best, but this one kind of worked out pretty good. And back then, earlier this year, I did carry the MR73 with utilizing this holster underneath a jacket. So it was the winter months, so it was colder. And it kind of worked out. You know, I did it. I didn't do it all the time, but I did carry this as a primary CCW. And then this pancake holster here, made by Kraft, it did not work out at all. The mouth collapses, and when you cinch a belt on this, it's just impossible to get this holstered up, see? So I would not recommend a Kraft holster, although they do apparently have a mold for the MR73 because it does fit pretty good. It just didn't work out for me. So I threw this holster into one of my holster bins, many holster bins that never to be seen again. So I wouldn't recommend that one. This one here was made by, well, this is a custom one. So this one goes in like this. So this one probably is the best out of these three. All right, covers up that sight. So this one was pretty good. This one actually hugged the grip way into the body. The fit is a little, I don't know, loose. See that? But it actually works out pretty good. Yeah, Sherrick. But anyways, just to kind of talk about this, I didn't end up carrying this as a primary CCW. If I did, I would have carried the speed loader. This is Safariland Comp 3. Would have loaded it up, you know, with this round here because I got a bunch of this on hand. It might not be the best self-defense cartridge, but I have it, so I said I'm going to use it. And this Comtac speed loader holder would have been on my belt line. And I tried it out for a little bit, but I guess it just didn't work out. So I didn't actually carry this MR73 as a primary carry. Now I would, you know, I definitely would, but it's got a 4-inch barrel. As you can see, these holsters here, they're pretty big. So it would be difficult to conceal carry an MR73 underneath a t-shirt. Okay, under a jacket, no problem. So I just didn't go for it, I guess. I would have no qualms about carrying this revolver as a primary CCW, despite what some people say, being it's a pricey gun. Why the hell would you do that? And a lot of people were saying, aha, you know, you're going to shoot out, and it's going to get confiscated by the police, thrown into an evidence locker, never to be seen again, it's going to rust away. I don't know why people focus on that. If you want to carry MR73, a Court Mongoose, Wilson Combat, a Staccato, so on and so forth, we'll call it expensive handgun, so be it. As long as you're proficient with it and you train and practice with that said gun, it's fine. You should not focus on losing the gun in a good shoot, because let me tell you something. If you are involved in any type of shooting and you survive it, your loved one survived and innocents, you know, survive, and this gets taken away from you, thrown into an evidence locker, never to be seen again, to rust away, so be it. Who cares? Why do you care so much about that? You know, yes, It's a pricey gun, but it came into service when you needed it and you trained and practiced on the thing. It's a reliable gun. You had the pride of ownership, so that makes you want to get out to the range and shoot it some more and more and more. You know it inside and out. You survived. This will not be on your mind after a shoot. Hopefully that 1% you know, chance of that happening where you have to draw this and defend your life and your loved ones' lives and innocence never ever comes. But if it does, you got a phenomenal piece of equipment that's going to work. And you've trained and you practice with it. You know the thing inside out. You're going to get out of that situation. Other things, people were like, oh, that gun's going to break. Aha, you know, you bought a piece of junk. Shopwee factory, they employ a bunch of idiots. I'm like, what's going on here? Beretta doesn't know what they're doing. Customer service is terrible. So that was the other aspect. So when I knew I wasn't really going to carry this as a primary CCW, I decided to, all right, let's put as many Magnum rounds through this as I can to see what would happen. That also went by the wayside because I started to do that. I don't know. I'm going to guess maybe 600 rounds of Magnums have gone through this so far. And for me, that's a lot. That's a lot, and that's very expensive. Now, I do have a large inventory of ammunition, so I do have a ton of Magnums, a ton of, you know, 38 Specials, 45 ACP, 9mm, you name it. So I do know that it's got to be almost 600 rounds of Magnums have gone through this, with the rest of that going through a 627 Performance Center snub nose, because I started to carry that one. But if you look at this revolver here, I mean, the finish is still intact, okay? It shoots like a dream. It did not go out of time. There was no situation where the trigger wouldn't reset. If you look inside there, you know, the finish isn't peeling off. I was getting so much negative feedback from people on this MR73. I just could not believe it. It was just so weird. Like, people hate Beretta so much. There are a lot of haters on the Shopwee factory. What can I say? This revolver right here has been working out very well for me. I enjoy it. I like shooting it. You know, it's going to be a turn line ring around the collar no matter what. I don't know what to tell people. It's going to be a line inside there because you're opening and closing the cylinder. The blooming is still intact, but people say, oh, it's all going to peel off. Oh, you bought a piece of junk. Well, I wanted to put like at least 1,000 rounds of Magnums through this just to see what would happen and kind of document this. But again, that fell by the wayside. So I doubt I'm going to do that. I mean, I'm going to take this revolver out from time to time, but I have moved kind of on to, okay, so this gun here and some of my DASAs, like I said, the Beretta Storm, I'm really enjoying that out of the blue, which is interesting. So I haven't shot a 1911 in so long. It's kind of scary. I shot a revolver for a long time, for the past, has it been 2 years now? So I think that's why I'm getting pretty good at a DASA. And then, yes, I started firing some of my striker-fired guns I got. But anyways, I don't believe I'm going to carry this, is what I'm saying. And I don't believe I'm going to continue to put a lot of Magnums through this revolver to kind of like test it. Kind of just going to have it on hand. It's a very nice revolver. I'm not going to get rid of it. I love it. The Court Mongoose, I love that one as well. So they're going to be kind of like range guns for the time being. I didn't really go all out and start shooting more Magnums. So this is, I got a ton of this stuff. So this would have been the carry round of choice, even though it may not be the best bullet design. I just have a ton of it. So I was like, I might as well just use it. And then utilize it with a Comtech speed loader holder on the front with a Safariland Comp 3 as my, you know, source of spare ammo. Just didn't ever work out, I guess. So just wanted to make this video to kind of talk about real talk. If you want to carry some of this as a primary CCW, I would go for it, man. I do want to say that after firing this with these Trausch grips, like a lot of Magnums through it, this rubber underneath the beaver tail stuff right here, this area right here, just tore up the webbing of my hand where I had to put Band-Aids here. It was crazy. But these grips are phenomenal for, we'll call it, combat shooting with this revolver. It just really locks everything in. You can control this revolver with the Magnums, but just know this rubber down here is going to eat up the webbing right here. That's the one thing I didn't like. I was like, it was annoying. I was like, damn. But other than that, I shot this mainly in double action only for the majority when I was shooting this. I rarely cock the hammer back on this thing to fire it in single action mode, but I think this is a very good combat revolver, despite, you know, its cost. Yes, can you get a Smith? Of course, of course. But if you get a MR73 for carry, go for it. That's what I would say. And yes, the bluing may start coming off at the high points here, but that's what happens with any type of carry gun, right? I mean, I was laughing when I saw something, I was reading something where these guys were upset about their Glocks and their SIG P320s, where the trigger guard is. Oh no, see how it's like kind of like polished there because of wearing in a holster? People get upset about that. Are you kidding me? Like this one guy was reading a SIG P320. Oh no, my the trigger guard, the front of the trigger guard is all turning shiny. But that's what happens when you use a Kydex holster. If you use a leather holster like this, eventually it's going to start, you know, tearing the bluing up a little bit. You know what I mean? So I don't know. It's just it's interesting how people think, I guess. If you have a gun for carry, understand it's going to wear. You're going to shoot it a lot. It's going to wear that way. You're going to draw it from a holster and reholster a lot. There's no way around it. So just, I guess, put things into perspective. If you want to carry this gun, so be it. But no, it's going to get a little beat up. And will it go out of time? And like, think parts will break inside? I don't know. Maybe it will. I don't know. I didn't get to that point. So for now, I'm going to put this thing away. I am still going to enjoy this revolver because this is like, yeah, definitely one of my most favorite revolvers in the stable. But we'll see what happens. I know a lot of people ask me about the Spore revolver. And just quickly, I am interested in the Spore revolver. However, there's something about it that's drawing me away from it. I think Spore, what they have to do is they really need to link up with a firearms manufacturer in the United States. So, as you know, Nighthawk brings in the Mongoose, Court Mongoose. Beretta brings in the Manurhin MR73s and stuff like that. They need to find a firearms manufacturer that will import their revolvers, the Spore, into the U.S. And that'll probably help start things up. I am interested in the 283 carry with a 3-inch barrel, or the 284, you know, carry. I guess that's their kind of standardized line, or their club edition. But I don't know. We'll see what happens. I'm not in any rush at all, and I just don't have that like super desire like I had with this MR73 to get it. But anyways, all right. So that's just some real talk on carrying the MR73 as a primary CCW. I never got a chance to do it. Will I do it? I could. We'll see what happens later on. But I know at this time, yeah. Okay, people are kind of surprised and upset about that. But we'll see what happens. Just stay tuned. All right, guys, leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.